In this video, we're looking at the dispersion of white light when it enters water. So I have a beam of white light coming into this interface between air and water at an incident angle of 45 degrees. We're going to assume the index of refraction for air is approximately equal to 1. And then this spreading out of the colors in the white light, or the dispersion of the white light, is caused by the fact that different colors have very slightly different indices of refraction when they pass into the water. In this case, we're told that the red end of the spectrum, those are the longest wavelengths, has an index of refraction of 1.331 for 650 nanometer red light. And then the violet end of the spectrum, those are the shortest wavelengths, I have an index of refraction of about 1.339 for 400 nanometer violet light. And we're simply asked to get the angular size of this rainbow of dispersed light. So we want to get the angle of refraction for the red and the violet and just take the difference between those. Now to get the angle of refraction for each ray, we just use Snell's law, and I'll post a link real quick to where Snell's law was first introduced. And I'm going to refer to the air as material 1 and then the water as material 2. And so N1 is approximately equal to 1, so that's gone. And theta 1, that's the incident angle of that ray of light entering the water, that's 45 degrees. And our goal here is to solve for theta 2, and I'm going to do this in general to make things faster. So we get sine theta 2 is 1 over N2 sine theta 1, and then we invert the sine function, and we find our refracted angle theta 2 in general. That's going to be the inverse sine of 1 over N2 sine theta 1. So then we just look at the red light, and I get theta 2 red, and that's the inverse sine of 1 over 1.331 times the sine of 45 degrees. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 32.09 degrees. I'm just keeping a little extra precision because we're dealing with a pretty small effect. And we do a similar calculation for the violet light. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 31.88 degrees. So I can see in the way this turned out, the angle for red is bigger. Remember, angles are measured with respect to the normal. So that's what we're talking about. There's the angle to the red. I can see that's bigger than the angle to the violet. And that actually means the violet has been refracted more strongly than the red. Now we just get the difference in the angles, and we have the angular size of this rainbow. And when I take the difference and round it to the hundredths place, that's 0.21 degrees. And that's it. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.